In this example, we are given that in a circuit, a resistance of 40 ohms and a capacitor of capacitance 1250/9 pi microfarad are connected in series across an AC source of 500 volt, a watch is having a frequency 120 hertz. We are required to find the effective current in the circuit and phase difference between a current and source EMF. In this situation, we are given that a resistance and a capacitor are connected in series. So, in this situation, the circuit impedance can be directly written in phasor form as R phasor plus XC phasor, which can be written in magnitude as R square plus XC square. The value of capacitive reactance XC, we know it is given as 1 by omega C, which is 1 by 2 pi FC. If we substitute the values, here you can see what we are getting. This 1 over 2 pi frequency we are given at 120 hertz and the capacitance is 1250/9 pi. In microfarad, so this will be into 10 to power 6 and this will be in ohms. Here this pi gets cancelled out and this 9 will be 3 and this will be 40. And the denominator will be 80 multiplied by 1250. This can be written as 3 into 10 to power 6 by 10 to power 5. So this will be 30 ohms. So the capacitive reactance here is 30 ohm due to capacitance and resistance we are already given as 40 ohms. So the circuit impedance will be root of 40 square plus 30 square. We know this is equals to 50 ohm, that is the total impedance of circuit. If we calculate the effective current in circuit, so circuit current can be written as IRMS is equals to ERMS by Z. Here the value of AC EMF for the source is 500 volts, so this can be written as 500 divided by 50. So the effective current in the circuit will be 10 ampere, that will be the answer to this problem. Here we are also required to find the phase difference between current and source EMF. So this will be the phase of impedance of circuit, and as the overall impedance is with capacitive component, capacitive reactance component, then we can see that current will lead the potential difference across the series combination of R and C. And the phase angle of this circuit impedance can be calculated by the phasor diagram as we take R here and 1 by omega C phasor in this direction. So the value of Z can be calculated from here, and this is the angle phi, which is the negative phase angle of the impedance. So we can directly write phase angle of Z is this phi, we can write as tan inverse of XC by R. So in this situation, this will be tan inverse of here the value of XC is 30 and R is 40. So this will be 30 by 40, which can be written as 10 inverse of 3 by 4, which is having a value 37 degree here. So this 37 degree will be the answer of this problem. And here we can say, due to the capacitive component in the circuit, we can write here current phasor will lead EMF phasor by 37 degree. This is the answer to this problem.